Go. Leave. There is no joy for you here.
I don't think I actually have a new encounter. I'll toss in... I don't know, there's not that much I can toss in. Dead King's Hall? Sure.
More than anything, I am proud of my array of curses.
This is a new one. On every successful combat without gauntlets, the player loses a ring. Hmm. That's a weirdly specific thing. Alright, well, I guess I'm gonna lose all my rings then.
It has finally come to this. I am tired. It has been too long. Yet life. Life will not let the candle be snuffed. I want to know what lies beyond that door. Yet, I will not go easily.
That actually hit me. And that was a successful combat without wearing gauntlets, so I guess goodbye one of my rings. Ooh. That's a lot of money.
More health to work with. Much good mate do you.
Charity 4, Lone and Noble Trader. Noble Trader's pointless because I don't think he's gonna take notice of me. Loan, I don't remember what that does. Charity 4, I don't really have that much food to give away. Well, actually I do have a pretty good amount of food. And I do have a lot of money. It's true. I kinda wanna hoard my money for getting rid of curses, though. Nah, let's go back and do it.
Descend ever deeper into the subterranean pit. You do have a charitable heart.
Hello, hello, take 10 food.
Or at least you have had, thus far.
Oh wow, you can actually give him 20 food. Let me root around in your sack, old man.
Choose from these options.
Is either this one or this one? Yes. One game card and the token is mine. That was, what, look at the other places on the map? That's completely pointless because it's all revealed. Let's get the money here.
With only 3 food, you'd better hope to finish this quickly, or hunger will finish it for you.
Oh, I'm fine, calm down. There's a priest, and hopefully no dog.
A chance to buy more food. You must be relieved.
Maybe I should just sell my rings before they disappear because of my curse. You know what? I actually probably should. Yeah. I suppose we can do the loan. Sure.
Again, a token is at stake.
Take my 10 gold. Thank you for the token.
Very nice indeed.
After 10 steps, player draws 3 gold cards. That is very good. That is some serious interest.
Bound once more, seeking the heart of it all.
Need to count my steps now. Whenever a weapon ability is used, the player consumes 1 food. Okay, that's pretty bad, but it's not the worst one. The worst one is the one where you can't counterattack.
It would be so easy to create a game that merely defeats you. A game in which you stand no chance, also completely unfair. That is not how I work. I refuse to play in such a manner. Our game is fair, and you will be defeated fairly. All who sit here must face their personal representation of pure, bestial power. Welcome to yours.
Okay, this sounds really interesting. Minotaur Maze. None still breathe who could tell a tale of these gargantuan beasts. They are dauntless in combat, and their attacks are unstoppable. The scriptures say that the mages try to enslave the minotaurs to their will, but they would not be subdued. So the mages locked the minotaurs away in ancient prisons, in the hopes that they would never be disturbed.
As you plunder the secrets of your memories, you'll gain new cards. Some you'll wish you'd left untouched.
You find your path blocked by a vast maze. With no way around, you enter. At the heart of the maze, you find yourself confronted by a furious minotaur. What will you do? Well, fight it, of course. Never fought a minotaur before. This should be, interesting. I'm kind of scared. Okay, minotaur is... It's a minotaur. It's fucking huge. And that weapon looks like it has range. And this is a very large battle arena. I'm kind of scared. Alright, thankfully it seems very slow. Bait the attack. Okay, it has a charge. Oh, that range. Alright, is there any environmental stuff I can do? Traps? This guy did not beat the dungeon. I'm so sorry. There is this thing. Oh, shit. Alright, so the best thing to do is probably wait for him to charge, I think. And then do 2 attacks? Yeah, looks like it. Alright, so this one's gonna be slow. Here's another skeleton that didn't make it. Sorry, friend. Better luck next time, skeleton. Yeah, this is gonna be slow. No, I only got 1 hit. Oh my god. This thing probably has like 2,000 hit points.
Oh,
Can I make it hit something that would, like, speed this up? What if it hits one of these things that has fire? You think it would do something? Yeah, let me see if I can make him hit one of these things that has fire on it. Maybe he'll, like, knock it down and it'll burn his face. Come on. Nah, he doesn't want to hit it. I think this might be all there is to the fight. It's a cool encounter, but it seems very time-consuming. Nah, there's no point in trying to interrupt him. Is there anywhere I can make him, like, charge off the map? Like, someplace that doesn't have a guardrail? I mean, here's kinda... It does have something there, but it's not much. What if he charges into this? Would this, like, break? I don't know if it'd matter, though. I mean, even if this broke, what does it matter? Guess we're about to find out. Nope. Two hours later, the hero finally died from exhaustion. I mean, I really like the creature itself. Very cool creature, well designed. I like the animations. Ow. Like, it just looks badass, it sounds badass. This encounter is pretty lame, though. I mean, the idea of it's cool, but the execution is just very, very tedious. Okay. After defeating the Minotaur, you notice carvings on the wall that may lead to an exit. You follow the carvings and, along the way, you find evidence that there were other explorers of this maze, and they found a way out.
If you found your way beyond the maze, I'm certain he can too.
He?
Imagination and illusion. Spells without weight and meaning. Yet they can wrap you in ribbons as easily as any other.
One night, you awake to find yourself enclosed in a maze of traps. Everything seems strangely familiar, like a nightmare from your childhood. A disembodied voice calls out, seemingly from the sky. Do not worry, escaping here is easy. It is all in your mind, is it not? Surely you have the willpower for that. The voice laughs and laughs, the sound receding away. What? Okay, I don't know what that said. It's all in my mind, huh? Okay. I don't know, these spikes seem very real. I wish I could move the camera because I don't know where the hell I'm going. Actually seems pretty easy so far. That's it? Huh. You wake the next morning wondering why you cannot shake the vision of a cat playing with a mouse, and the sound of a laugh, cold and cruel. That really wasn't too bad. Wait. You spend a restless night with your dreams haunted by visions of a strange demon who sniffs and says, "They say you visit the altar, yet you have no mark of the gods upon you. Begone." In the morning, you feel drained. One pain card. Oh, gee, thanks. I guess it doesn't like the fact that I visit the altar. There's the blacksmith again. No.
Across the ocean.
Nope.
Familiar trip down the river.
No, we have unfinished business. I'm gonna get lost in the desert, and then I'm gonna go into that fucking cave, and I'm gonna save those fucking assholes. Come here. Pray to the gods. Die to the gods. Don't die to the gods. Long lost tomb with treasure still inside. One weapon card, thank you. Not exactly the weapon I wanted. Does the same damage as the axe. Yeah, so I'll have to see how much that killing blow actually drains my health, as to whether it's worth it. But I'll take it for now. Okay, blacksmith.
Let us stake a token on their foolishness.
There's a 1 in 4 chance. There's a 1 in 4 chance. Okay!
A close call.
Finally!
In your favor.
Oh my god, for all I know there's probably another card thing that I have to do right after this one. But, let's see what happens. You are drawn to torchlight up ahead and discover the blacksmith and his son together, surrounded by a group of dead creatures. Look, I fought like 200 minotaurs down here and... Well, okay, that might be an exaggeration, but... Throw anything at my face, I can deal with it. My papa killed these beasts, but there's more coming, says the boy. The blacksmith is clearly injured and can barely stand. The boy speaks the truth, says the blacksmith. If you fight them here, give us a chance to get out. I will be greatly in your debt. Here they come, the boy yells in fear. The blacksmith and his son stumble out of the cave as best they can, away from the danger.
Ah, the rat man.
Ooh.
I am delighted to see him once more.
I guess I'm going
to
be testing out my killing blow. Hopefully I can kill one of these bosses in a killing blow, but I don't know if I can actually... Don't they have to be on the ground for the killing blow? I don't know. Ah, shit.
Ah!
Fuck. This is bad. Screw you, I'm leaving. Let's get this thing. Oh shit! Oh god. Alright, let's keep going around. Come back to that. Okay, we're in business. Keep going around and try to kill the lackeys. Try to kill the ads before going for the main bosses. That way I have less to focus on. Stop laughing, you asshole. Alright, let's try this. Killing blow? Oh shit, it worked! There goes 20 of my hit points, but I did just kill a boss in one hit. Okay. If it takes 20 hit points to kill a boss, then I can use it on the other one, but I'm gonna have 4 hit points left. This all day, mofo. I don't want to spend my 20 hit points, but if I don't spend it now and I lose and I go below 20, then I can't use it. Oh, ooh, that was close. Oh shit! Oh! Oh, oh. Yeah, so this Blood Crescent is actually amazing against bosses. As long as you have some health to begin with. After the battle, you follow the blacksmith and his son to the surface. I owe you a great debt, friend, says the blacksmith. Finally! I get the token. Give me a chance to heal these wounds, then visit me whenever you need some equipment. I'm guessing once I add his encounter into the deck, that'll give me, like, one free equipment or something. Alright, I need food, and I also need to heal my wounds. Ooh, the rat cleaver's so good! Every third blow from undead enemies is reflected back against them. Oh, it's light armor? Nah. That's a good weapon. That's a very good weapon. I need food, though.
I'm sure you're grateful for that. Sail away and see what you will find.
Lose 5 gold for every fail and 10 gold for every huge failure chance card. That's fine.
I was left these simple pieces, and from them I have built a palace of memories. A convoluted maze that few will ever reach the end of. Will you be one of them?
Okay, 1 out of 2. One more and I finally get this coin. Hey! I think I'm actually gonna get it. Along the back of the large tent, you discover a row of cages. Strange creatures look at you mournfully through the bars. You stop at the sight of a beast with the body of a lion and the head of a man. "Please help me!" the beast exclaims. "I was born a man, but then I came here. They did this to me." You open the cage and the beast jumps out, saying, "Bless you, stranger. I may live out my days as an animal, but at least I won't have to perform for those devils." Draw 1 blessing card. But wait, I can't get blessings. Do I actually get the blessing?
Many of these blessings are too good for the likes of you.
The crappy blessing anyway. The man-beast turns and flees between the other cages, swiping at them in fury as he passes. Various other cages break open, releasing a number of unusual-looking beasts that fly away. Sometime later, you find yourself standing at the edge of a forest. Oh, that's the same thing I said before. Okay. I've been trying to get that for a very long time.
Ooh. Chance. Everything is chance in the end.
Do I spin the wheel and risk losing equipment? No. And losing equipment is something that happened with just a simple failure. A huge failure would probably, like, turn me into a man-beast.
A portal and a wizard. Or at least an apprentice. It reminds me of days past.
Alright. Small fee for a destination thingy. Nah, I don't really care. Goodbye. What's wrong? Kill the bastards when I see them, gotcha. Please don't be way behind me. Oh, it's on the very next square, excellent. Let's refuse to deal with them and let's punch them in the face. 3 of dust, that's it. Yeah, it's gonna be easy. I should be pretty close to 10 steps, right, for the gold? Or wait, was that last run? Or was that this run? Where after I take 10 steps, the loan is going to be repaid? I can't remember.
Now, this is my kind of travel. Ah, that is one of my favorites.
Minus 10 max health whenever the player gains a new curse, which is going to be on every floor. Why, thank you.
We're all merely pieces upon the board. The circle repeats without end. Does the rook understand the oblivion that engulfs it when it is placed back in the box? Does the king understand that he truly rules over nothing?
In a busy town, you meet 3 disheveled soldiers. We got drunk last night. One of them explains, and gambled away all our gold. And our helmets, another joins in. We'll trade food for any helmets you have on you. Our captain's gonna have our hides if we turn up without them. He always says, only a fool goes into battle without a helmet. You realize my helmet is like a circlet, right? Like it's a little jewel, basically. It's like something somebody would wear to the prom or something. Sure, you can have my jewel. You hand over your helmet, and they give you some food. Okay. The soldiers pass the helmet around, each trying it on. This is a strange-looking thing, but I guess it'll do the job. Have you got another? We'll pay more for a second helmet. I don't, I'm sorry. The soldiers lose interest in you and begin to harass every other armed person they see. Okay, so you need two helmets to actually be able to get the card, the token. Man, when the higher-ups see that helmet, it's not even a helmet. They're gonna be so screwed. They're idiots. They're complete idiots.
I will happily wager on the outcome. I do not think you have what it takes.
Okay, I've got curses up the ass, so I should be able to do this. Ah, here we go. The house demon sniffs and then says, approvingly, "You have the stench of the truly accursed about you. You may enter." Inside, you discover a labyrinth of dark, smoke-filled rooms occupied by devils, demons, vampires, and all manner of ungodly creatures. You end up seated at a table with a scaled figure, risking your soul in a game of chance. Okay. I don't remember agreeing to that, but sure.
Ooh. A choice. Select your desire.
I believe I tracked the huge success. This one? Yes.
Nicely done.
You roll the bones and hope for the best. Great success! Your opponent hands you a tiny vial of liquid. Drinking it causes you to vomit uncontrollably for a few hours. If this is what it feels like to have a great success, then I don't want to know what the other options did. Afterwards, though, you feel more hearty for having survived the experience. Your maximum health is doubled. Whoa! Oh my god. In the morning, you stumble out into the sunlight. You turn to say goodbye to the little house demon, but the door has vanished. That is very good. That max health gain is ridiculous. See if we can get some food. Hell, let's purchase some heals, actually. What about curses? Anything I can get rid of? Player loses a ring, irrelevant. Hungry blades, whenever a weapon ability is used, the player consumes one food. I wouldn't mind getting rid of that. That I don't care about. I might want to get rid of corrupted soul, but then again, with a max health of 180, does it really matter anymore? This one I care about. Let's get rid of this. And if I get this, I can't afford food. Nah, I'll leave it. Bit of food, bit of healing. Don't want to get too much healing because I can just naturally regenerate.
Better than trudging along a muddy road, certainly.
Yeah, I'm gonna turn back because there's plenty of gold just left out for me here. Ooh.
Greed. If it were not for greed, then who would play at this game?
Bring it on. Could have been worse. It just means I got spotted. Better than falling on my face and slipping on a banana peel. Ooh, shit, that's a lot of traps. Alright, screw you. You die. Goodbye. There goes a shit ton of my health, but whatever, it's worth it. Do I even do anything, or do they just... Are they just gonna die from the, all the thing? Oh, shit! I need to get out of here. Alright. Shit. Fuck! This is actually a very bad place to fight them. They're kind of just dying from the traps, though. There we go. Doing the splits. Ooh, 3 game cards. During combat, press right bumper to become ethereal, avoiding all damage until your next attack. Oh, so it does kind of do what I was thinking, where it kind of makes you invincible for an amount of time. But it looks like to balance it, they've made it so that it's only until your next attack. So what can you use that for? If it literally lasts forever until your next attack, you could use that to cheese traps. Because you could just, like, stand in a flame of a trap or something and have the enemies burn themselves to death, I guess? But that's pretty lame. Short of doing that, I can't think of how this really gains you anything. I don't know. Seems kinda crappy.
I'm sure you're grateful for that.
Choose to discard or put back on top. Okay. Reinforcement? It's good. Inferno Potion? Good, I guess. Assassin's Creed? These are all kinda good. Yeah, these are fine. So I can put specific ones on the top. So is there something I want to draw next, specifically? I don't know what a movable object does, but it probably ruins my movement speed. I think I'll take the helmet. Yeah, so I should get that one next.
What traps can you contend with?
Hello, friend. Oh, whoa, my God. Okay. That was close. Ow. Okay, I have a hellacious max health, but I don't have much health. So, do I go back to the healer? Or do I go for the gold? Let's go for the healer. Wait, where's the healer? Oh, there it is.
A horse is a fine companion. I'm sure you'll leave this one in time. You do not seem to have the temperament for friends, even in the animal kingdom.
No, the dog! Fuck you!
Better than trudging along a muddy road, certainly.
Oh no, it's the bad curse. In combat, on each counterattack, the player inflicts double damage and loses one food.
Every card drawn from your thoughts and your memories. Every card tainted by your view of the world and your single-minded purpose. The same singularity of purpose that brings you here.
Time for some jacking. King Jack, Little Jack, come on. Now, do I lose all my health using my Blood Crescent Blade or whatever it's called, or what? Sure. No, I used all the wrong opponent. Fuck. Alright, it's kind of bad. I can't use it now. Fuck. Can't hit me? What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do? Huh? Oh. It doesn't last forever. Got him. Choose a card to keep. Okay, what does this do?
With the help of this armor, one man defeated an entire army, only to drop dead the moment it was removed.
Okay, so put it on once, never take it off. How do I shower? During combat, this armor grows stronger with every blow sustained. What does this do again?
I remain amazed at the power you have touched in your life.
During combat, press right bumper to activate Fire Form. Look, I don't know what that means, but that sounds fucking awesome. So, let's do it. Screw Spirit Walk.
Really? Is that what you're going to do?
They want my blood? No. Fight me. Ow. Ow.
Huh.
He writes a number of strange symbols on your skin with your blood, and calls to the Dark One to give strength to his willing servant. Oh. Thank you. Cool. I really need to get healed. My max health is ridiculous, but I just don't have any health. One food for $6? No. Then again, if I start starving, I'm gonna die very, very quickly. Yeah, I guess I'll keep buying it. Terrible price. Really, really bad.
Caves and caverns. One cannot hope to find adventure without a little delving now.
The player cannot choose a combat encounter choice if there are any other choices. Ooh, that's really bad.
I am not the first to deal the cards, nor are you the first to play. I do not expect we will be the last.
Okay, this is a much better deal. I can't even choose to attack them. Holy crap, that was quick. I kinda need stuff though, like, I need a new weapon. Yeah, I need to explore. And there's plenty of gold to actually subsidize my travels, basically, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, I can afford to go all the way here. And then go back.
The mark of the serpent. There is no doubt that you have traveled an interesting road, adventurer.
You find a casket buried in the sands. As you reach for it, a voice calls out, "Stranger, stay your hand! That casket bears the cursed serpent's mark." Eh, whatever. Gonna open this shit. You cautiously break open the seal, releasing a burst of stale, dusty air. There's nothing inside. Little do you know that you've released a plague upon the world and everybody is going to slowly die and the entire human race is going to become extinct. Good job. Run! Get some more food. Fucking dog. Fucking piece of shit. Fuck you. Perfect.
I'm sure you are grateful for that. Greed and avarice. Your desires define you and have shaped your destiny.
I'm gonna be greedy. Let's go for it.
Choose from these options.
The huge success was the top one. I think it's this one. Yes!
I did not think he would achieve that.
Two equipment cards, thank you. Every successful combat grants a player some gold. Gonna be freaking rich. Oh god, I'm gonna be really rich. Oh man, but I want to become Inferno Dude. Oh. Do I want to turn into Lava Man, or do I want to bathe in money? Can I become Lava Man and bathe in money and turn it into a bath of molten money? Can I do both? I can't do both? Alright. Oh, that's right, I get crap tons of gold for actually completing that. I want to become, like, freaking stacked. With money. Yeah. That's my goal for this run. I want to become freaking rich. I don't care if I die. I just want to be rich. I want to be a greedy mofo. Longer life. I think that increases my max health and doesn't actually give me a heal, I think. And I don't need more max health, although, of course, it's never a bad thing. Actually, what I really need is food. Okay, not bad.
In this case, to be fair, you are intruding into their home.
Oh, that's right, I can't even attack as the damn curse. Alright, just hide in the cave. You settle down and wait for the storm to pass. Several hours later, you emerge from the cave unharmed. Uneventful.
Are your senses acute enough to detect what lies here?
Oh, I have to flee! Well, I guess I have to try to flee. Halfway down the hill, you lose your footing and make the remainder of your escape tumbling headlong over rocks and through scraggly bushes. When you, eventually, come to rest at the foot of the hill, you're no longer being chased. You clamber to your feet and brush yourself down, sheepishly. To pain. That's nothing. Drop in the bucket. That's not a drop in the bucket. Okay, I need to get rid of this damn curse that makes it so I can't attack. I'm never gonna become rich if I can't attack, so if I can't attack, I can't use a mercenary contract, and I can't become rich, and if I can't become rich, then I'll never be happy. You know, gotta do the thing. Healers are really good for getting rid of curses, right? Yeah. Oh, I have the Wrath of Food? I totally forgot I even have this. Alright, let's get rid of Cowardice. And let's get rid of Wrath of Food. That way I can counterattack. I'm poor, but it's okay. I'm gonna get so much money. I want them to give me a battle that has like 50 people of dust, you know, 20 skeletons, just throw them at me. More people, more money.
I worked long and hard to make that particularly painful. Ingenious, don't you think?
Eh, that's fine.
You close on your final foe. Soon we will meet. Regardless of who wins, know that I have enjoyed the game.
Okay, wait a minute. This level's extremely small. Is this actually the final floor? Because if it is, then I don't care about money. Which means I should equip Inferno Potion. I think this is the final shot before the end boss. Well, I have no money, so I guess it doesn't matter. I mean, it could sell stuff. I want to go back so I can heal. Using my food, but I can't seem to select the card behind me. Oh, there we go. Okay, it was sticky. Or something. Alright.
Such strength. If only all problems could be solved with brutality, you would be a champion.
Is this you?
Now we fight. I had hoped it would not come to this, but I knew it must. I could have built this trap to be flawless, yet I included the seeds of my own demise. I must. You must. This is the way the world turns. Without change, there is only stagnation.
The final confrontation with the dealer. Undoubtedly the toughest test you have ever faced. There have been dealers before, but none so adept at the game as him. Bring it on. Time to change into my Inferno form.
Our final confrontation begins.
This is so cool.
I will not fall as easily as the other opponents you have faced.
Oh, this is really cool.
The three rulers of the Court of Dust return once more. The microcosm reflects the macrocosm.
This is freaking awesome. This is badass. This is an awesome, like, board to fight on, whatever you want to call it. To make it even cooler, I'm in my Inferno form. Or at least I was. Now keep in mind, I do have the Blood Crescent Blade, so I could just kill them in one hit. But I don't know what's coming, so I'm gonna be cautious. Bring it on! Come on!
I have let you come too far. I have become soft. This is your end.
Oh, it's QTEs! Alright, bring it on. I think I fucked up. Nope, apparently not. Okay, this is kind of silly. That was a killing blow and it didn't even kill him. I just used a killing blow on my Blood Crescent.
Again, my skulls come to the fore. Fight and see if you can emerge victorious.
I'm guessing it's disabled for this fight, so that's probably pointless. There's a lot of stuff going on here. I don't really know what's happening. There's too much stuff.
I
can't see! I can't see! This is actually really tense. Alright, I just got the caster, or the range guy. I want to take out this thing. Oh wait, no, he just got reaved. Damn it, he just got revived. Alright, got that, that's good. Alright, just took him out again. Just got revived again. That might mean I just have to take this big guy out, I don't know. I don't remember how he works. I think it does mean that. Alright, I'm gonna focus on him. Yeah, I'm gonna focus on the main guy. Well, I mean, here, I'll focus on this guy for a second, I guess. No harm. But when there's a good opportunity, I'll focus on him. Here we go. Perfect opportunity. It's when he does the big... the, like, beam thing. That's when he's super vulnerable. There we go. Got a bunch of good hits off there. Use my crescent blade, but I don't want to do that. Too low on health. You get me down to like 5 hit points or something. Shit. Oh, is he dead? Oh, he is dead. Okay. We're good. We're good. We're good. We're good.
Fate ends here. As well as you have played, I say no more.
Gonna chop off your fingers, you bastard!
You must still resist the family of Rax.
God, no.
If you wish to challenge them.
Fuck. Honestly, I'm probably dead here. Oh, fuck. Where do I even start? There's so much to dodge here. I need to take out this fucking sprayer thing. Caster. Oh, sweet. Just do some damage for me. Thank you. Oh. Alright, got him. 16 hit points. 16 hit points. I didn't think that hit me. Shit! I'm gonna focus on one so I can kill it. Seven hit points. Oh, fuck. Oh.
I cannot be defeated so easily. Death comes for us all. Though not, of course, for me.
Lasers. Ground lasers. Goddamn ground lasers. Oh, I feel like I was on the very last phase. I don't know. There might have been a lot more phases, though. I don't know. Jeez. You know what would be really, really fucking good for that fight? Time heals. Oh my god, that would be so good. I don't know, considering I was just kind of messing around and choosing reckless paths, I don't think that went so bad. Ring of Engorging? Is that, like, ye olde Viagra? Is it a... Is it a cock ring? I don't think it's meant for my finger. The Ring of Engorging. Blacksmith's Gratitude. Yeah, so that's the one where I'm pretty sure he'd give me free equipment. At least he better, after everything I went through. Giant Eagle. Devil's Carnival. That sounds cool. Detonator. With only three uses, that must be very powerful.
Again you face me. Again you are a fool. Until now I have shown compassion. You would be best to test me no further.
Alright, let's take a look at the new cards and then end the episode. How many more charities are there? Let's throw in all the new ones, see if we can toss out any. I feel like I should toss out Wheel of the Gods. Secret Society I definitely want to keep, because that, if you pass that and you get double your max hit points, that is extremely good. Are there any that I hate? Okay, Devil's Carnival, I don't want to be doing that if I've already have the coin. Royal Treasury is good. The Apprentice is kind of pointless, it's just a filler card, so let's toss that out. And yeah, I think that's good. Okay, Blood Crescent. I'm not sure about it. It seems really good, but it often takes like 20 to 30 hit points. At least when you're taking out a boss, so it's very expensive. But it can be very good. Do I have any new items? I should have at least a ring, right? Armor of the Watcher. Hold on, one of these armors was light. Which one? Occult Reflection. Yeah, that's a light armor, so let's toss it. I don't think I want to be using any light armors. Clairvoyant Helm. Let's go replace the helmet. I don't remember what they do. Oops. A hit on the player gives the player's next attack a 25% damage bonus. I don't like that. Detonator, lightning crash. Hold on. Toss in the ring. Ring of Engorging. I love that name. I think I need to toss out some of these. I have a lot of these. Okay, so Spirit Walk. I've confirmed I don't like it. Inferno Potion. It sounds cool, going into Inferno form, but in practice it didn't seem to be great. I'm not sure how much of a damage bonus it gave me, but it didn't seem like it was that much. So I'm gonna toss that. And let's throw in Lightning or Detonator. Throw in Detonator. Let's get rid of Chain Bomb. Actually, no, I haven't used Chain Bomb. Let's get rid of Alchemical Silver. Throw in Lightning Crash. Anything else I want to throw in? Clairvoyant Helm. Any shitty rings? Player receives plus 5 health for every undead. That's actually pretty good. Every artifact used, the player receives plus 5 health. That's not very good. I'm gonna toss that. Okay, and I think we're good. Alright, well, that was a run that I really did not expect to get to the end boss on. I was just kind of messing around, basically just going with the fun, weird options, or the really precarious options, just to kind of try to get tokens and stuff like that. And I got a bunch of tokens, made a bunch of progress on that front, and somehow managed to stumble to the end boss in the process. Don't know how, but I think I almost defeated him. Almost. Next time, dealer. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far. And I'll be back soon.